So I try that we should overcome that is very popular in our club.
So because I don't like
the judges,
I only know the result. So I think you're the
contestant because and then probably we need to promotion in our website, our Toastmaster homepage, to make it friendly and to attract people. This is the only way we have to make club. I think we should break the vicious cycle of the virtuous cycle. Vicious cycle becomes virtuous cycle.
I know you love discuss, but hello. Okay, so let me invite our president Alex. Can you share what is your biggest challenge in Toastmasters? How did you overcome it?
I had a lack of experience to be a leader when I was young, and my first time to be a leader is in the spring conference in 2014. I was an organizer for closing ceremony, and I overcome it because of two ways. First way is that I think I have no experience in leading, especially in spring conference, especially in spring in closing ceremony. So I create something new that nobody done before, something new. So I have nothing to bother me, so I can go ahead simply. And second is that I find some useful and also supportive helpers to help me to complete the whole event.
Thank you. Thank you, Alex. Very inspiring. Ivy, would you like to share? Come on.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
What was my biggest challenge in Toastmaster? I think it's persuade people to tell people that Toastmaster will truly help you, will truly help you forever and ever in your career or in your personal life. And did I overcome it? I think that this is my
challenge.
So
I'm still doing it
because people are hard to believe that if you can do it, then they can do it.
Yeah.
So you can just tell them and show them. So I take every challenge. So when Alex asked me, what is my biggest challenge? Mm-hmm. I said, actually, no. Being a leader is so easy. Being a follower is much difficult. To me, yes. I have a problem to following the orders. So yes, being a leader is so easy, but so difficult to tell people that, you know, it's so easy to just speak English. It's not that hard. So yes, so far, I'm still doing it.
Okay, good. Thank you. It's a big world, it's a big family. You can dig in whatever you want. Does anybody want to share? One more? Richard, come on. Richard.
Is there coffee?
You get married.
And I just told Alan, right?
Yeah.
My biggest challenge in Toastmaster is I haven't delivered a speech more than 1 year.
Exactly. So many people have this problem.
Yeah, and I think there's also the problem in my club can attract new member to join us. So I think I'm one of the experienced member in our club,
yeah.
But I didn't do well,
yeah,
in club, so I can attract newcomer to become our member. So how did I overcome it?
Yeah.
I think I have to deliver a speech as soon as possible.
Make it as your challenge next year.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank
you for sharing. Yeah. Thank you so much. Okay. So overcome your challenge. Bring you satisfaction. Okay. My story is, remember my boss doesn't really like me because he doesn't really think that I am able to communicate well. So I take that as a challenge. And then joined Toastmaster. That was 4 years ago. So I commit myself to practice on the stage practice, and also join the contest. And the result, here's my sharing for my story. Oh, this is when I face a challenge, I ask myself three positive questions. This is very positive way. So help me my brain to switch my mindset to see something like, what can I learn from this? How can I strengthen me? How can I help others? So how can I learn from this? I believe that I'm not that bad, boss. I think I can communicate well. I think I can make it one day. How can this strengthen me? I think this experience will help me to prepare the better next challenge. Third, how can I help others? I manage a department of many people. If I can use my word, my communication to inspire them the best, why not? So when I ask this question, yes, I have to do it. So I commit my energy, my time, my effort, my wisdom, my everything to do it. And here's the result, can you have a look? This is my consistent commitment to join all the contests every single year. So that was 4 years ago. I joined the human speech. I make it to the district final, which is in Taiwan final. And 25, this is spring conference and fall conference, joined the different Chinese, English, district and division final. Last year, I joined the Chinese prepared speech in the individual evaluation. And this year, I also joined the international speech in Chinese, also English table topic. This is my commitment. And every single time is a contest, I raise my hand and go and join it. Do you think I don't have time? Do you think I have enough time, extra time to do it? No, I'm the same as busy as everybody. I only have 24 hours. But you know how stressful it is to join the contest. You know that everybody attend is really, really, really stressful. But can you imagine that this is my C1 speech?
Oh.
Wow. And I practice more than 300 times.
Wow.
Am I stupid or what? No. I ask these questions. Why do I have to make such an effort? Because I believe I can. Believe that one day I can communicate well. So here I am today. I'm standing here. I'm not comfortable. I'm not so nervous. I'm comfortable to speak with you. I'm confident to connect with you. This is the proven record, which I commit myself to do it. If I can, as Ari say, you can.
Yeah.
Right? And the result, what is the result is, last 2 months ago, my company, every year they have a competition. So I got the best department award.
Wow.
Which means that, you know, all the effort pay off. So this is the benefit of joining Toastmasters. Another story of mine is that in Toastmaster, in my club, Lester Lin, which is the founder of my club 4 years ago, he usually play guitar at the beginning of the club, just when he wants one song, yes. But when Lester disappeared or he's busy, there's nobody singing the song. So I challenge myself, I say, hey, one day I'm going to do that. I love singing, but I don't know how to play guitar. So what I do is I bought a guitar 1 year ago, and I book the lessons every single week. And my teacher is a very young, cute guy, 20 years old. What happened is, I asked myself, how can I learn from these young kids? You know, for me, as a young kid, how can I learn? But since I commit and challenge myself, I said, okay, I'm going to learn from him every single week. So I went there every single week, consistently, without stop. And what happened is, this is 1 year later, which just happened last month. I also play and play the guitar in my club. So this is I take that as a challenge and make it better. And last month, my teacher the young guy, he asked me, so we have a recital, which is the final performance. Would you like to join us? And the only questions I asked him, if I'm not playing well, will you be embarrassed by it? And he said, no, that's okay. So here I am, I get on the stage and I play. After 1 year consistent doing it. Why? Because I believe that if you're consistent, you make yourself do it every time and constantly, consistently, persistently, you'll get into your DNA. It will become yours. Wow. That's my belief, and it really happened. And this is my story. And another takeaway I want to share with you is that learning sometimes transfer. Transfer means that you need to apply your skill in learning. Apply by doing it and use outside Toastmaster world, using the real world. Without transfer your performances, it means zero result. Believe that or not. This is very, very important. So my belief is I have to keep doing it. Doing it outside work. I apply that in my job, apply that in my life, apply that in my family life, my friend's life, my company. So I hope that you can remember this. This is very, very important point. So challenge helps us to grow first skills. What skills you can grow in Toastmasters?
Communication.
Yeah, speaking, communication, what else? Leadership.
Mm.
Right. And a lot of things for me is my music skill. It's a big thing, it's a big pool. You can dig in whatever you want. Some people get a lot of different skills. Anyway, so second, relationship. Relationship is a group of every single thing. If you are not having a good relationship with your boss, or with your subordinate, with your team, with your teacher, with your students, with your parents, with your friends, and you screw, your life is suffering, it's a torture. So relationship is really, really, really important. But take that challenge for me in Toastmasters. I actually appreciate more people because we have a lot of youngster university students in our club. And I cannot believe how much I learned from them. So I actually developed more appreciation and thankful heart in my heart. And that at the end of result is I really have gained more networking and relationship with them. So relationship, you can help you to grow that relationship. And I help you to grow in your job, in your life as well. Networking. And grow your satisfaction. If you conquer your challenge, you will gain a lot of satisfaction. You have more confidence. You have more competence. But here's a tip of mine. First is celebrate it if you see any small improvements in your skill or your relationship. That's very important. It's an attitude for life. So what I do is if I'm doing well in my evaluation, and I will celebrate with my husband, we will go out and celebrate. We use that as, it's not an excuse, it's really literally to celebrate it. But in the same time, we do the review as well. Right, so celebrate is attitude for life. We have a short life, only one life. So celebrate if you can. So challenge help us to grow skill, relationship, and satisfactory. Here's some of the example in my club. This is our club members and also my friends. They're all very outstanding. Why I put the picture here is they were champion in all the contests. Yeah. Joseph Calvin is an American guy and he won the prepared speech in Taiwan, and he also won the Chinese prepared speech as a second. Yeah. And Paul, he 4 years ago, he really have a stage fright and then really not comfortable to stand on this field. But 4 years later, he's not a very famous instructor, trainer, motivation speaker, and I'm very proud of him. Edward Lin, he won the table topics number one in Chinese and also prepared speech. And what happened to his life is he take his life as a challenge. He said, okay, I am going to be a professor. So he applied the university in States and applied successfully. So he bring his American wife and a newborn baby to States, to New York, to study PhD. So it's very successful. I just forgot to introduce Joseph Calpin. He take the challenges in his life. He study Chinese history in Taidang University.
Yeah.
And he used Chinese as his dissertation, his final. He wrote it and then he presented so well and he get his distinction in his master's degree in Chinese.
Mm.
He take on new challenges every single time when I see him. Every time when he finish meeting and he doing so well, for example, TME or GE, he's so well, he done it so well, perfect, and no mistake and anything. He still will come here and say, Queenie, anything I can improve? He has that attitude, it's a willing attitude. He take on the challenges. He strive for the excellence. So, Lester Lin is the founder of our club, TGIF. He is the guy, master guy, he create all the champions. He challenged himself very, very much as well. Like, he think that doing the individual evaluator is really the best of best. So he challenged himself for 10 years. After 10 years, eventually he got the number one champion on the stage, in the national stage. And he's doing very well in his business as well. So what I want to say, Douglas Gilman, he just won the, what did he do? He won the
humorous contest.
Yes, humorous contest, and he also won the individual evaluation. Yeah. He just joined, and he's a very successful finance head in Yahoo. So he's doing these guys. When I see them, they have a one common is they dare to take on the challenge, and constantly, really, really try. And because of that, they have that attitude also applied to their job, their life, and their life is also really improving now. Now, wherever you are now, you are perfect. You are perfect wherever you are now. You are not a little bit more or a little bit less, you are perfect. But it depends on your mindset and your attitude to strive for excellence. So, my questions to you tonight is what new challenge would you take up in Toastmasters? You can write one or two, okay? One or two. And I would like to ask Alex to pass this little note, okay? And please write on your name and write on the challenges you think you might be specific, okay? For example, Richard, you could say, in next year, I would like to deliver 10 speeches. That's specific, okay? Or you can say, I would like to reduce my R into less than 2, okay? Be specific. Or you can say, I would like to take an office job, leadership role in Toastmaster. Whatever is big or small, make it as a task, okay? So please take 1 minute and write it down. Yeah, any direction is fine. First, write on your name. Second, write on your new challenge in year 2018. Remember to be specific. Finish?
Yeah, finish.
Spanish, pass to Alex. Okay. Pass your notes to Alex.
Finish?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Yun.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. These are the notes you wrote now. Whatever it is, it's okay. It's a challenge you promised yourself. Not me, not anybody, it's you. Okay. So I would like to form a group. This is close group, study group, safe group. And Alex will be the president, so me will be there. So we will check each other, follow up each other. So after 3 months, we will see, we'll ask each other, how did you do it? Did you actually improve a little bit? Did you actually make progress? Or you just forget about it? Okay, it's okay to do it, but this is a promise for yourself. And after 6 months, which is June, which is next president, so maybe we'll double check with that. And remember, this is a follow-up activity for this workshop. So remember what I say, that if you learn something but you do not do it, it means zero result. So let's do it together, okay? So in conclusion, what I just say that challenge help us to grow, number one is?
Skills.
Number two is? Number three is?
Satisfaction.
Yeah, that's good. So this is the final thoughts, notes I will give it to you to look at. This is from C.S. Lewis, one of the philosophers, the writer. He say that hardships often prepare ordinary people for an extraordinary destiny. The hardship, some of the hard stuff, could be your challenge. It could be something that you write now. But remember that although we are ordinary people, but our life can be really extraordinary. Believe that and you can. Okay, here's my workshop. Thank you.